coaches talks about being, you know, and even gives the example of a tiger or you think of a lion or whatever. So that's kind of what I think of too. But if you look at the second definition, it says unrestrained zeal or extremely intense. So intense can mean different things. Sometimes intense, people think of that as sort of up in your face or whatever, but intense can just simply mean that you're passionate about what you do. But the third definition, if you go all the way down to the third definition in the dictionary, it says furiously active or determined. So you're really determined in these conversations that she's talking about. And so I looked at what Suzanne Scott herself says about fierce conversations. And she says, when you think of a fierce conversation, think passion, integrity, authenticity, collaboration. Think culture transformation and think leadership. So those are the things that she thinks of when she thinks about fierce conversations. Okay, so one of the things, and she talks about authenticity quite a bit. So this is a nice picture of, we went to the Riverwalk. Hasso might recognize this. I really liked this bridge. We walked several times up and down the Riverwalk. So I took pictures of multiple bridges, plus that, you know, applies in mathematics, so I took them for various reasons. But it sort of applied here too, because to really find your authentic self, to find who you really are, you have to think of yourself as a person. You have to think of yourself as a professional. But you have to build a bridge between those two things. So you can't completely take, I think oftentimes we think we have to take that personal element out of being professional. But then you're not really being who you are. So if you want to be who you are, you have to make that bridge and that connection between who you are personally and who you are professionally.